Atypical Season 4 is out, bringing this heartwarming coming-of-age tale to an end. We've seen Sam get his first girlfriend, graduate, and head off to college, and in Season 4, it was time to see him take on an even bigger adventure.
Because I'm going to Antarctica.
Now let's take a look at your burning questions after the finale of Atypical. Will there be a season 5? The fourth season of Atypical was announced as the final season, so no, there won't be a fifth series. But as hard as it is to say goodbye to characters we've grown to love, showrunner Robia Rashid told TV Line this final season is about hope and journeys of adventure. Zahid has spent 4 seasons being Sam's guide on all things to do with the ladies. After a bumpy time in season 3 thanks to Gretchen,
I forgot how hot she was. Did you forget how hot she was?
In season 4, they become closer than ever as college roommates, though that isn't without its complications.
There's too many rules, it's impossible.
When Zahid gets testicular cancer, Sam decides to learn how to drive so he can bring him home from the hospital after his operation. Has there ever been a friendship as pure and wholesome as this one?
Sorry, I didn't ask first.
It's okay, at least it's tight.
The old Zahid would make a joke about that, but I've grown.
UCLA has their eye on Casey, we learn at the end of season 3. While this is good news for the budding athletic star, the pressure of early morning runs and the weight of Clayton Prep's team on her shoulders begins to take its toll. Her anxiety even presents itself in bloodied fingernails, picked away due to stress. When she bails on a big race with a UCLA scout attending, it seems like she's about to quit track altogether. Instead, she requests to return to her old school's track team. But what about UCLA? Well, that's where Elsa's habit of getting involved comes into play.
Emily works at UCLA. Mom. And I'm not saying you have to go to UCLA. Just go meet with a nice lady.
It seems her chances of getting into UCLA are very much intact. After breaking up with Evan at the end of last season, Casey and Izzie give being in a relationship a go. As sweet as they are together, it's not all smooth sailing. Casey, for one, will do anything to try to help her girlfriend, including cheating on a test for her. And Izzie, facing difficulties with her mother, finds it challenging to witness how caring and supportive her girlfriend's parents are in contrast.
You have this charmed life, and usually it's whatever, but right now it's really hard to deal with.
When things fall apart for Casey after the big race, Doug admits he thinks Izzie brings too much drama into her life.
The thing that's making her life so hard right now is you.
Leading to a brief breakup.
I don't want to be the reason you don't do the things you want to do.
This is short-lived, however, and not only are the two back together by the finale, they're both in talks with UCLA.
If either of us gets in, that person needs to go. Whether or not the other one does. Promise?
Promise.
Forehead promise?
Forehead promise.
Paige may have started out as Sam's practice girlfriend, and after reconnecting in season 3, they start out the final season very much together, though still without making it through to deserted Olive Garden. When Paige gets a huge opportunity to build habitats in Georgia, Sam encourages her to take it, even if it means they break up.
I never thought I could find a girlfriend, and then I found the best one in the world, you. But now you need to go and I need to go. So I think maybe we should break up for a while.
Sam and Casey's parents have had some difficult times in their marriage over the course of the show. Doug, understandably, had difficulty getting over Elsa's affair in season 1, and the two even talked about separation. But in season 4, it seems they're doing much, much better. This season, Sam's parents have struggles other than marriage to contend with. Elsa, always wanting to take care of Sam, has to deal with him not being at home anymore.
Come home.
Maybe I should.
Yes. I'll put the sheets on your bed, and if you hurry, you can make it in time for dinner.
Meanwhile, the sudden death of Doug's best friend leaves him struggling with suppressed grief.
Chuck had a heart attack.
He seems unsure about what to do with his own life, that is, until he realizes just how many vacation days he has, meaning he can accompany his son on a really special trip.
You have 54 vacation days?
54 to zero.
Oh man, I mean, if I had 54 vacation days, I'd pack up my car and I'd head straight to Myrtle Beach.
Which brings us to our final question, does Sam end up in Antarctica? Sam's opening line of the very first episode of Atypical is about his dream of going to Antarctica, and his final storyline is about that actually happening. Not everyone is so supportive of his plan when he announces it initially.
Sam's never left the country!
But soon enough, they're all on board to get him there, from Casey helping to train him to Elsa making some Antarctic food. Even the last-minute cancellation of the college's Antarctica program can't stand in his way.
I don't need a program to go to Antarctica. I can go on my own.
Doug ends up asking Sam if he can accompany him on the trip.
And I have all these vacation days saved up. And, well, can I come with you to Antarctica?
Okay, you can come.
The last shot of the show is, appropriately, Sam smiling in the snow, finally in the icy continent he's always dreamed of. And what better way could there be to end the show? For more on your favorite Netflix shows, make sure you subscribe to the channel.